Hello, everyone, and welcome to RTC TV4. My name is Galen Rensel, alongside here with Dakota Hayden.
Howdy, howdy.
We're about to get everything ready here for the tip-off. Today's matchup is between the Casting Comets and Tippecanoe Valley Vikings.
Yes, sir. Should be an interesting matchup here tonight. Or not tonight, this morning, actually, to throw things off. Starting at 11:30 today. And this is continuing a part two on the Cast and Shootout. Valley lost to Oregon Davis, putting them in here, and the Comets lost to South Bend Career Academy, putting them here for tonight.
It's a double elimination.
Yes.
So they lose this, they're done. If they win, I think they play later.
I think that's how it goes. I could pull out the sheet if I had it in front of me. I'll look for it during halftime. Ooh.
Tippy Valley starts off with a three.
Nice three. Solid. We got Kinzer with the ball. Getting over to Eli. Eli putting it back over to Kinzer.
Sirius Casty gets it on the wing. They're trapping the wing right there. As you see, they're trapping Douglas right there.
Yeah, they're not letting
Miles
him go for those threes.
Underneath the ball, gets the Rands. Rands
put it up.
Put it up. No good. Rebounded by Tippy Valley. Here they come up the court. They're not wasting any time on the offensive side. Pulls up a 15-footer.
Open
no
for
good.
That one.
Rebounded by Kinzer. Kinzer will bring it up the court here for the Comets.
Comets need to get moving. Get something working.
Kinzer gets the Douglas. Douglas drills around up on top. Gets it to Kinzer. Kinzer crosses over.
Drives in.
And he's going to get a reach-in foul. Push, actually.
Two shots. No two shots. No, they were calling numbers. My bad.
They get in the Douglas.
Douglas three.
Ooh, way off.
Airballed it. Eli just can't hit
those
threes.
It didn't really seem like he took time to shoot it. He just hurried up, catch it, put it right up. Got to come down with it, get some momentum going.
Kinzer's showing off a little ball movement going, bringing it to our side of the court.
Kinzer picked up his dribble, gets it to McDonald. Don drives baseline, gets a foul called. It's going to be before the shot. Be taken out of bounds.
Kinzer now.
Trying to get someone open. No one gets it out. That's going to be a layup. It could be a layup for Tippy Valley. I believe that's going to be on Rands coming up behind him. Come down on him.
Valley's going to get placed for two shots.
And the first one's rolling, and it goes in.
It's a nice toilet flush-like movement there.
Second one falls as well, and that puts him up 5-0 here in the first with just 6 minutes. 6 minutes remaining.
Comets need to put us on the board here. We're in need of
Power
some points.
Now up on top with the ball. Ooh, passes away. Kinzer thought maybe he tipped it, but I didn't see no tip. Same with the refs.
Valley now.
Fires up a three.
No good.
Offensive rebound.
Comets couldn't get on the rebound there.
Gets it down low. Traveled before he dribbled. Go to the Comets ball. So far, the Comets still haven't gotten on the board yet. They still haven't gotten their first shot to go in yet. Actually, I don't even think they even tried to shoot it. They just tried those couple of drives. Besides Eli shooting that three.
Yeah.
Finds Eli underneath, puts it up
there
for
the
lamp,
go.
And it's good.
All right, got us on the board with two. Valley now.
I mean, Caston's defense, the way they have it set up, like when the offense gets the ball on the wing, they want you to drive baseline, and then they trap you right there. So it's like, that's why they play at an angle. Like, they want you to go baseline so they can trap you right down there on the corner. But that falls for the Vikings, and that puts them up 7-2.
Howard passes it over to Miles. I was going to drive in and get back out to Eli. Eli's going to drive in, put it
Kinzer,
to Kinzer.
Ooh, I thought he was my...
Bit of a faulty pass.
And that's going to be a over and back. That's going to go back to the Vikings.
The comment's not looking so good starting off the first quarter. Oh, steal.
Steered by McDonald.
There we go.
Yeah, that's what you're trying to say. Ooh, that's going to be a travel before.
Right back to the Vikings. Yeah. Rally now. Trying to get something moving for him.
Goes
drive
up
in.
Baseline right over. Train goes down trying to get the offensive foul called, but nothing there. So he goes up with 2 points. Kinzer now with the ball dribbling up. Kinzer gets the Howard up on top. Back to McDonald. McDonald getting trapped hard out there on the corner. This will be a push foul, number 20 for the Vikings.
And that'll still remain Commons ball. Brady Hartman coming in for Trenton Howard.
They get it in the Kinzer up on top now. Back over to Douglas. That's reaching foul. Thought it might have been a travel, but.
Yeah. Kinzer now with the ball. It's over to Miles. Back to Kinzer. Kinzer with the three.
Kinzer's going to fire up. No
doesn't
good.
Land.
If he would have followed a shot, he would have had it right back to him, but recovered by Hartman. Hartman gets a...
Miles tried to get
trying to do
over.
Something, but turns it over to the Vikings, and they're...
Get on that defense.
Vikings
driving
in up. And he gets a foul called. Didn't look like much contact there by Reyes. I don't think he really.
I didn't
see that much. That's why he was looking around like, I don't even think I even touched him.
Well, regardless, Vikings will get their two shots.
Looks like Shane Lom, number 13, the freshman, will check in for the first time here for the Comets. And he'll check in for number 23, Reyes, as Reyes has two fouls on him just here in the first.
First shot doesn't land it for the Vikings. Second shot doesn't fall either. Brady on the rebound. Got it to Eli, who got it to Kinzer. Kinzer gets it over to Miles.
Kinzer's trying to have him get the ball to him. He's open there up on the wing. Fires up a 15-footer. That's going to be tipped, and that's going to go out of bounds. Oh! I thought that was a little tipped by the Vikings there. That's why I thought. That's why Hartman was trying to save it there.
Yeah.
So they can get it back, but, huh. Guess not.
Comets need to pick things up here. We're still trailing by 7 here with about 3 minutes left to go. Less than 3 minutes left to go here in the first. Spun him off.
Pulls up a 15-footer, did some ball.
You get on that rebound, Comets, come on.
Man. Kids are just standing underneath there.
Not doing anything. Almost had a steal there by the Vikings.
They get down low to the freshman. Shane Lom goes up with it. And
brings it in. There we go.
Now the Comets trail 11-4 here in the first quarter. That was the second. The first quarter is actually taking a lot of time. They're going to pop fire up a three. No good.
Get on that rebound, Comets.
Vikings, I mean, you can tell that they have more energy than the Comets right now, aggressiveness and everything. I mean, they're following their shots. They're going after every ball that's up in the air.
Miles now with the ball. Hit to Kinzer. Someone needs to get out there and help him. Shane Lobb over to Miles again.
I mean, the Comets passing game has been very sloppy.
Everything's just looking bad right now, honestly. Valley now.
Today seems like a Saturday. I woke up. Feels like a Saturday.
It does. It's only Friday, though, believe it or not.
Valley. See some great ball movement here by the Vikings trying to get their open shot. The thing is about the Vikings so far, I know, is I mean, they don't really rush that much. I mean, they just take their time trying to find the good shot. Making the Comets actually do defense, and that's going to, the more they do that, that's going to really wear them out.
Yeah.
See, he drives up, baseline, pulls up. No good. Rebounded by Shea. Oh!
No good. Comets ball.
It's going to be a foul under 24 on the Vikings trying to reach in there and get the ball back. I didn't really see that much. I mean, I guess there was quite a bit of reach in.
Thirty-six seconds left on the board. Kinzer getting the ball over to Eli. Eli launches it over to Miles.
McDonald.
Miles back to Eli.
Comets can't handle the pressure.
Over to Brady.
Barber now with the ball.
Over to Miles.
The intensity on the Viking side is very high right now, and that's going to take a charge as McDonald drives in. Vikings go down, so that's going to go to the Vikings ball with 8 seconds left remaining here in the first.
Valley now. Three.
Fires up a three. Oh, wow. They get that one going, man. That wraps up for the first quarter. Vikings lead the Comets 16-4.
Man. And
the thing that the Vikings are doing to stop the Comets from scoring is they're really pressing them. A lot of intensity on the defensive side. They're trapping the corners. They're trapping the wings. And it's hard for the Comets to get past that.
Yeah.
So, I mean, they're going to have to figure out something to get past that.
Yeah, to get past that good defense that they're putting
out.
Yeah,
to get past that defense pressure.
Comets also need to get their shots to fall for them. Eli has not been having a good time with his threes. Yeah, he wasn't shooting.
Last night, he wasn't. He was around 0 for 3 or 0 for 4 or something like that.
Yeah, he wasn't hitting them at all
right,
last night.
Over here in the corner earlier in the first, airballed it.
And with the Vikings giving them a hard time when they try and drive in, they got to get something going here. Plow in play now for the second quarter. Kinzer now with the ball for the Comets. So to Miles. Miles to Eli.
Yeah, there's that double team.
Miles tries
to get another sloppy pass there by Comets, and that's going to... They're saying it's being tipped by the Vikings, and it's going to remain Comets ball.
Miles now with the ball. He gets it all the way over to Luke. Kinzer to Miles again. Comets aren't getting anything to move. Miles tried to get into
Kinzer. That's going to go to the Vikings as a bad pass. Was that? That was by McDonald, right?
Yeah. Vikings now.
Open three for number 24, but they decided to shoot it. Oh, it looks like number 40 is going to be 3 seconds underneath in the middle of the basket. Not washing himself right there.
Comets ball now. Miles gets it over to
number 4 in the loud freshman. He looks like he checked in the game earlier in the second.
Howard tried to get over to Miles. Tipped out by the Vikings. Going to stay Comets ball. Getting a bit sloppy on the passes here in the second quarter. I don't know what's going on.
Well, I don't think they figured out that much over that first quarter. Yeah. As they were talking. Not seeing any progress here so far.
Kinzer gets over to Miles. Miles then back to Kinzer. Kinzer with the three.
Fire up a three. Boom.
Nice.
Now he can knock those down. He's a guy that, you know, if you give him a little space, he might knock those down once in a while.
Comets now on the board with 7. Let's get some momentum flowing here. Vikings driving in. He's going to put up. Easy 2 for the Vikings. Kinzer gets it over to Miles. Miles get it back over to Kinzer. And then to Miles. Miles with the 3.
Ooh, you could tell that was off as soon as he shot that one.
Vikings now with the ball. Getting it around the arc. You can do anything
nice
now. Drive it in.
And it goes in there for the Vikings.
Easy too for
the Vikings now lead the Comets 20-7 here in the second with just 5:15 remaining.
Foul call on the Vikings for sticking his foot out there to block the pass. Luke getting it over to Trenton. Trenton back out to Miles. Miles is going to get it over to Luke again. All the way over to Kinzer, stolen by the Vikings.
Bad pass. There comes the Vikings up the court. Pulls up.
Doesn't get it.
Offensive rebound. Puts it right back up for 2. Offensive rebounds. Bad passes are killing the Comets in this game right now. The timeout's going to be called by Coach Evans for the Comets.
Get some talking going, get something figured out. We're trailing, but not all hope is lost yet. Now, while we're sitting on that timeout, let's see if I can find in this mess of papers. What?
Trying to find the bracket thing.
There it is. All right, we're right here.
So if we win, if we win this game,
we'll move on here. But if we lose, we move here. To
what time will they play if they win?
Six. And if they lose, six again too. So I think we're here either way. It'll just be in a different gym if we lose. Trenton, get over to Kinzer. Kinzer then over to Lau.
Kinzer gets it over to Lau. Lau down to Howard. Back out to Kinzer for that three. No good. Offensive rebound for Howard.
It's a Lau. To Trenton, over to Kinzer, over to Eli. Eli with the three. Can't hit those threes. It was closer than his last attempts, though. Valley now with a long pass.
All the way over on the other side of the court. That's going to be a trial. That's going back to the comments.
Kinzer now bringing the ball across the court. Get over to Eli. Eli's going to drive in. Get out to Lau. Get back to Kinzer. Kinzer's going to get back over to Luke. Luke back to Kinzer. Kinzer over to Eli. Eli into Trent. Trent to Kinzer. Kinzer over to Lau. Lau into Trent. Into Kinzer. Trying to get something moving for him. Three by Kinzer. Airballed it. Way off. Things are not sitting good for the comments here right now. Number 13, Hunter Shane Lobb, coming in for Trenton Howard. Vikings now. The jumper doesn't sit. They're on that rebound. Vikings will take it out of bounds. Be Comets ball. 21, Brady Hartman coming in for number 4, Luke Lau. About 3 minutes and 5 seconds left to go here in the second.
McDonald with the ball now. Kick ball. At number 20 on the Vikings.
Vikings seem to have a habit to stick their feet out during the passes. I bet it's intentional, though, but still. Shane Lobb with the ball. Back to McDonald. Over to Hartman. Back to McDonald. Ooh. Almost stolen.
Scary pass right there.
Eli gets it out to Kinzer. Kinzer into McDonald. Well, driving in, get to Shane Lobb. Shane Lobb with the jumper.
Travel. He looks like he's playing pretty timid, Shane Lobb. I mean, he's a freshman. I mean, as big as he is, I mean, if he just gets the confidence that he needs, I mean, he's going to be a really good player in the next 3 years.
Yeah.
If he continue to work at it, yeah. I mean, he's going to be a good player. But right now, he's just too timid. It's kind of understandable for a freshman, but.
Right. But even still. Vikings trying to get an opening. They're going to keep it on the arc. You know, drive in. Staying on the arc. Put it for a jumper. Doesn't land. The Comets couldn't get on that rebound. Then they're going to drive in. Doesn't get it, but he gets the foul.
Two shots there. For the Vikings. The first one falls there. Second one falls as well, and that puts them up 24-7 here in the second, with just 1:43 remaining. Let's see if the Comps can get a good bucket here.
Hartman needs some help.
Yeah, hold. Reach in foul number Vikings.
Kinzer now with the ball. It's over to Miles. Now it's to Eli. Eli getting all the way out to Kinzer.
I don't know what it is, but I mean, they just can't find no openings. You know what I mean?
Yeah. They're trying, but they can't get it going.
They can't figure it out. I'm not sure if that's on the coaching part or that's on them. Or
I don't know.
They're just passing around on the wing. There you go. There you go. Then you get it down low to Moore, to Shainlaw underneath.
Shooting foul to put Shainlaw on the line. We also got a bonus working for us. Doesn't land. Vikings on the... Not bad. I figured he was going for two. Easy 2 points by the Vikings.
Seconds remaining here in the second quarter. Let's see. The Comps need at some type of bucket here. Gets it down low to Shainlaw.
There he goes
for two. With two.
We can do that more, we might be able to catch him here.
Yeah. I mean, they were just working down low. Nothing's going for him out on the outside because they're trapping the wings in the corners. So you got to get somehow to get the ball inside because you don't have enough time to fire up a shot unless you set like a double stagger or some type of double screen.
Yeah.
Or flare or something.
Vikings getting it in, putting up.
Ooh, tried that left-handed little hook shot. That wraps up for the first half. Comets trail 26-9. We'll see you right after this short little break.
All right, and we're back.
Hello.
After the halftime.
Start the second half is about to get underway as Tippy Valley will start out with the ball. Excuse me.
26-9. Comets got to get some momentum drifting their way. Or else we'll be in the elementary gym 6 o'clock tonight facing, I don't know who we'll be facing, but we'll be facing somebody 6 o'clock in the elementary gym. And I'm not looking forward to filming in there, so if we could get something turned around for us, that'd be great. Valley now had him inside for an easy two. What? Kinzer trying to get the ball into somebody.
Yeah, they get the ball in. They do the McDonald. Back to Kinzer. Tippy Valley's coming out and just pressing him. Start the second half. All right, let's see what type of plays the Comets can run this time. Hey, McDonald driving in, and there's going to be a reach-in foul called.
So number 34 for the Vikings. Still Comets ball.
Douglas passes out to Kinzer. Picks up his dribble, gets it over to Douglas. Douglas goes around the pick. Then it C. Rands.
Gives it back over to Kinzer. Trent.
Drive baseline.
Do something other than what
back
you are doing.
Back door pass to Douglas. Goes up with the 15-footer.
Oh, does it land? Rands on that.
Almost rebounded by Rands. Rands kept fighting for that ball and got a jump ball on it.
Let's get a thing moving here. Kinzer launches out to Eli. Realize not going to drive in. Put it up.
He does get a foul called, and I think that should send him to the line for two shots. Maybe not. I guess not.
Nope.
I guess it was before he went up with it. So that's going to be taken out of bounds. Let's see what they can get going here.
Kids are looking.
They get in the Howard. Once in a while, Howard, the ginger milkshake, number 20, once in a while, he might shoot a three. And when he does, it goes in.
It does.
But
he
never shoots it, though.
No.
They get it down the way. McDonald fighting for a layup.
It
and
up.
It goes in.
There we go. Gets up to 11 double digits here in the second half. Valley now. Watches it out. Gonna drive in. Now he's gonna drive in, jump it up.
Off the rebound. No block out there by Rands. It's gonna be fouled by Rands, and that's gonna send him to the line for two shots.
Not good.
First one falls for the Vikings. Rands comes out of the game and Shanloff checks in for him.
The second one falls in suit. Kinzer now. Getting the ball over to Douglas. Then he gets it over to Miles. I was going to give it back to Douglas. I was going to drive in a little. Tried to get it over to Kinzer. Swatted out by the Vikings. It's going to be Comets ball. Kinzer gets it over to Eli. Eli's going to drive base, put it up. Doesn't go.
Travel. Yeah, dribble first before you can move.
Miles and Kinzer exchange hands. Kinzer trying to shake his suppressor, gets it over to Trenton. Trenton now getting it back over to Kinzer. Kinzer's going to drive in for a jumper. There we go. Comets now only trailing by 17. Gotta get something moving for him. Vikings lose ball, stolen by Howard. Howard gets it over to Miles. Miles over to Kinzer. Comets need to get moving on the offensive here. Let's go. Kinzer now. Timeout by the Comets. Full 60-second timeout. Coach Evans must have not saw anything good or had an idea. Huh. 3 minutes and 44 seconds left here in the third. It's a doozy, that's for sure.
Yeah.
Diamonds breaking out, taking back the court. Comets will have possession of the ball here after this timeout. Kinzer now at the ball. Gets it over to Trenton. Back to Kinzer. Kinzer with a deep three. Couldn't get on that rebound.
Kicks it out, fires up. Oh, that's his second or third three of the game. I think it's his second.
Trenton now with the ball. Almost got stolen by the Vikings. Swap by Kinzer is going to place the Vikings on for two. And both shots go in for the Vikings. Putting them up 35 to our lowly 13.
Get it down low. You had Howard underneath there open for open pass, but.
Jumper by Eli doesn't fall. Vikings now. They'll put it up. Kinzer gets the ball back over to Trenton. Trenton into Kinzer. It's swatted out from the pass. Vikings ball, easy layup. 2 minutes left in the third. Kinzer gets over to Trenton. Trenton tried to get into Shane Lobb. Ball gets stolen again. Another easy layup for the Vikings.
A 30-second timeout would be called by the Comets. Comets trail 41-13 here in the third with just 1:36 remaining.
Not looking good at all. Both teams just retaking the court here with a minute 36 left on the clock. Kinzer with the ball. Gets it over to Miles. Miles is going to put it up. Miles is going to get put on the line for two shots. Yeah. everything situated. Niles throws up a shot. Taken by the Vikings. Vikings now. Getting something going.
There's an easy layup there for the Vikings. 35 seconds remaining here in the third.
Thomas now, Kinzer. They'll just drive baseline and put it up.
Yeah, timeout is going to be called by the Comets.
Easy 30-second timeout by the Comets. Timeout's up. Comets are back out on the court. Vikings following along. Kinzer gets it out to Eli. Eli hands it back off to Kinzer. Back to Eli. They're trying to get something going. Kinzer with the three. Nails the three. Put him at 17 now. And three by the Vikings. Doesn't land. That'll be the end of the third.
That wraps up the third quarter. Comets trail. 43-17. Comets just can't find any open buckets to go in for them.
They were playing a better game last night, that's for sure. By the looks of it, we'll be playing here tonight again. We'll be back at 6 in the elementary gym. It's going to be a fun place to film, considering it is significantly smaller than the high school gym. But just enough to put a basketball game in there. Hopefully we can find a spot to set up. But nonetheless, we will be back again later tonight in the elementary gym. Unless we can pull off a miraculous win here and catch them up, then we'll be back in the high school gym. But, oh, I'm going to go out on a limb and say that might not happen. Vikings. High pass over to the Vikings. I think he stepped out of bounds there real quick. Comets ball. Kinzer checks it into Eli, who gives it back to Kinzer. Kinzer gives it over to Hartman. Hartman back to Kinzer. Eli's sitting open over there. Kinzer tried to get out to Eli, bounces right off him and out.
Goes to the Vikings ball. Man.
Faulty passes. Vikings now. Trying to get something moving for him.
There's a steal by Douglas.
Gets it over to Kinzer. Kinzer on the double, someone help him. Launches it over to Miles. Miles loses it. Gonna be a foul called on the Vikings, still Comets ball. Eli is over to Kinzer. Kinzer for the three.
Boom! Knocks that one down.
Splashing. Vikings now. He's around trying to get moving. Keeping the ball passing around, keeping around the arc. Comets need to stay on that aggressive defense. Gotta keep moving. Don't let them get an opening. And they try and shake him off. He's gonna put up a jumper. Doesn't land. Miles on the rebound. Eli now with the ball.
Lines over to Kinzer
for another three.
That looks good. Ooh, in and out.
Didn't land. Vikings now. Foul on 21, Brady Hartman for holding. Well, I heard the ref say. That's what the ref said it was. Three by the Vikings. No good. Pass is blocked by the Comets. Miles loses the ball. I think Rance has got a hold of it. Comets ball. Miles checks in to Kinzer. Miles. Pass was going to get intercepted by the Vikings, but they took it out of bounds, so it's still remain Comets ball.
Got about 4 minutes remaining here in the fourth. Comets trail 43-20. Rands drives in and gets a foul called. I believe that's going to send him to the line for two shots.
Yeah, it'll put him to the line. First one falls in for Rands.
Shaylob, the freshman, will check into the game for number 21, Hartman.
Second one falls in for Rands. Now it puts the Comets at 22-43. Now we just have a tad bit more than half the points. Three by the Vikings. Airballed it, shot it a bit over. Getting some movement going, put it in for two. Miles now with the ball. Miles gets it over to Kinzer. Kinzer's gonna drive in and put it up.
Ooh, almost had that one. If he would have just got the ball up a little higher, it would have went in.
Vikings now. Swatted out by Rands.
By Rands coming up.
That was nice.
There's a 5-second call there on the Valley. Great defense there by the Comets.
You know, we've seen a lot of that the past couple days. Went from not seeing any of that to all saw that happen twice, three times actually last night. Seeing it once here. Miles getting fancy with the dribbling, lost control of it. Vikings ball now.
Shaylob going up with the block, but he gets fouled.
Pushing foul on him. Still Vikings ball. That'll place him for two. First one's in. Second one doesn't land. Shaylob on the rebound. You know, I get it over to Kinzer. 2 minutes left on the board. Miles now with the ball. Get over to Kinzer. Kinzer with the three. Just threw it up there. Shaylob couldn't get on that rebound.
1:40 here remaining in the fourth quarter. Finds him underneath, goes up.
Doesn't go in.
Rebound by Rands. Rands gets it up to Kinzer, and he's going to dribble up here for the Comets. Gets it up to McDonald. Goes underneath, goes up, gets the foul call, and that's going to send him to the line for two shots.
Yeah, it'll put him on the line. First one doesn't go in. Second one doesn't fall in either. Vikings now passing alongside the arc. Get it in. Put it up.
Ooh.
Doesn't fall in. But they're on that.
I don't know how he gets his own rebound like that. You know what I mean? Like, I don't know. There's just no block out or anything.
They don't. They're not aggressive in there to get those rebounds. That's probably what's killing us. Vikings now. Looking for an opening. Seconds left here in the fourth. Taking their time to wear down the clock. He gets it in. Stolen by the Comets. Kinzer now with the ball. Kinzer gets it over to Eli. Eli with the jumper. Completely was way short for that one. 7 seconds and clock's gonna tick out.